All right, y'all, so I'm going to finish part three of addressing the occultist and spiritual community video. So I'm summing this shit up. So this is what I'm going to say, right? So this is the issue that I'm seeing in all these communities, y'all feel me? The issue is that niggas is just hopping from community to community. People be saying shit like, oh, I'm a Christian because of this and that. Oh, I used to be a Muslim because of this and that, or because they had certain beliefs that I agree with. Niggas are like, oh, I used to be Muslim. I used to be this. Oh, I used to be part of the spiritual community. I used to be part of the occultist community that glorifies dark. The only thing they glorify is dark shit. Oh, I used to be a motherfucking truther because of this and that. And this is the thing that my boy Corporal Chaos Counseling said, right? He said that the reason when he reacted to my questions to the occultist part one video, this is the thing that CCC said, right? He said that the reason that niggas join all these motherfucking communities is because they want to seek validation from people. They want to get patted on the back. It's because they are looking for niggas' approval. Folks be focused on the wrong shit, bro. People be putting all of their time and energy into the wrong type of shit that is not going to help benefit them. Like, for example, niggas are saying, oh, you know, to be part of the spiritual or conscious community or to be spiritual in general, oh, I got to act this way. I got to be this certain way. I always got to be nice and, you know, easily manipulate, or I've always have to be kind. You know what I'm saying? People are like, oh, I gotta have crystals in order to be spiritual. Oh, I have to always burn sage to be spiritual. Or people are like, oh, I have to be, find my soul tribe in order to be so-called spiritual, right? Even though those things, like finding your soul family, or, you know what I'm saying, or, getting crystals, burning sage, even though those things are beneficial, yes, but to a certain extent, all that stuff is a distraction from you. All that stuff is a distraction from you tapping into what they want to call the creator or source. You know, people think that, oh, if you find, oh, your soul family, this is what people think when they automatically find their soul family or people that are family to them that vibe with them spiritually or that vibe with them energetically. They think that, oh, when I find my soul family, oh, I'm not going to have to go through anything. You know, my soul family, they're always going to be there for me. They're always going to want to talk to me. They're always going to want to associate with me. But my nigga, I'm going to tell y'all something, bro. Your soul family is not always going to be there for you. They're not always going to save you from your shit. They're not always going to be there to support you, because everybody has issues of their own. Everybody's got problems, issues of their own. People, like I said, people, and not everybody, everybody's spiritual journey is different. You know what I mean? But there's going to be times, trials, and tribulations in your life where you can't rely, I don't care who it is, you can't rely on a family member to help you. You can't rely on your soul family to help you. My nigga, there's going to be times where you're going to have to just rely on yourself. Can't no one tell you or help you achieve a higher level of consciousness. Yes, people can give you advice on how, you know, how to do shadow work, how to work on yourself, how to achieve your goals, but it's not up to them to keep helping you. It's up to you to find out your purpose in life, to achieve your goals, to do whatever you put your mind to. Y'all get what I'm saying? But I know sometimes niggas beat themselves up because, oh, they're not doing this. They're not doing this to be called spiritual. Niggas are like, oh, I haven't found my soul family yet. My nigga, this is what the fuck I'm going to tell you. Don't worry about that shit. If you don't find your soul family, that's okay. Because the only person you have at the end of the day is yourself. Since we're talking about doing the work, you know what I'm saying, meditation, you know what I'm saying, what they call doing shadow work. This is the other thing or issue that I've noticed in the spiritual conscious community and the occultist community. The issue is, I feel like that most of y'all are being hypocritical. Most of you niggas are not practicing what you preach, because all I hear people saying is that people are, this is what the spiritual niggas are saying, and people who are in the occult are saying. They're saying, oh, when I say somebody is stuck on their spiritual journey or they need help, you know what I'm saying, on their spiritual journey, they'll tell niggas to, you know what I'm saying, they'll be tell people like, oh, do your shadow work. Oh, meditate, do this, do that in order to be spiritual or to be part of the left-hand path or whatever faith system that you may have, right? But I feel like most of you niggas are not even practicing what you preach. I feel like most of you niggas are not even meditating. Most of you niggas are not doing the shadow work that you need to do. I'm not going to say most of you niggas are not doing it, because I feel like there's some people who are trying to better themselves or who are trying to, you know, better themselves. Then there's some people who are doing the work, but they're being half-assed. They're doing a half-assed job. Y'all get what I mean? Y'all know those people who say they're going to do something, but they do it, but they're real late, or they're half-assed about that shit. That's what I feel like most niggas are doing. Either niggas are not doing the work at all, or they're just being half-assed, man. But this is the shit that I realized, y'all. And the shit that I'm starting to realize, man, about this whole spiritual community, the whole occultist community, the spirituality and the cult in general, bro, is that spirituality has become an organized religion. The occult has become an organized religion. I'm going to be honest with y'all, man. I feel like spirituality and the occult, niggas who are on the left-hand path, not all, but I feel like this whole spirituality and this occult shit has just became a motherfucking trend. And I even told y'all this shit. Even Destructive Shaman said that the whole dark shit, the whole occult, is going to become a motherfucking organized religion too. And that just came out the own horse's mouth. But anyways, man, this is the boo-boo that I have been seeing, or this is the boo-boo that I have been observing in all of these communities, like the conscious community and the occult community. Man, y'all got niggas claiming that they these niggas from these past lives. You got niggas claiming that they're Greek gods from a past life, that they're Egyptian gods. Niggas claiming that they some revolutionary leader. You got niggas claiming that they motherfucking revolutionary leaders from the Haitian War, from the Revolutionary War. Niggas are claiming that they're these types of fucking people. You want to know the sad and ironic thing about this whole boo-boo that be taking place in these two communities? The ironic thing is that nobody is using discernment at all, bro. Nobody is using their own damn brain that they have on top of their heads for a reason. Nobody is thinking for themselves. Nobody's questioning nothing or questioning anything like I do. People are easily fucking fooled and manipulated in these goddamn communities. You know what I'm saying? That's all I had to say about that. Then you got niggas claiming that, oh, I'm a shaman. Oh, I'm a healer. Oh, I'm gonna be the next big rapper. Oh, I'm a spiritual priest. Oh, I'm a spiritual teacher. I'm this, I'm that. To keep it a buck with y'all, niggas are claiming something that they're not. Then this is the other funny thing that I'm seeing, bro. You got niggas claiming that they're practicing aerokinesis, telekinesis, moving shit with their minds, moving shit with their hands and not having to touch the object, the paper, the glass bottle, the cup. Then you got niggas claiming that they're bulletproof. They're like, yeah, I'm the next Iron Man. Yeah, no bullet can penetrate through me. I swear, bro. I swear to God, y'all, try that shit with the pigs and watch what happens. You're gonna get 10 bullets up your ass and you're dead. I'm not saying that telekinesis isn't real, but I'm that type of nigga that has to see to believe, man. I have to fucking see to believe this shit. You know what I'm saying? Then you got niggas talking about for I don't know how many goddamn years since 2021, my nigga. Kala Al-Munra been talking about this shit too. He's talking about, oh yeah, you know, the sun is gonna activate so-called black people's genes, and yeah, it's gonna unlock the so-called junk DNA in us. And you know what I'm saying? We're gonna have superpowers, and we're gonna have this, we're gonna have that. But nigga, I have yet to see this shit, nigga. I have yet to see a nigga fly. The only nigga that is making real, legit telekinesis and aerokinesis videos is my boy Chief Why Not. Shout out to my boy Chief Why Not, because he even admitted that most of these telekinesis videos that people are uploading are fake as fuck. And I believe the shit that he's saying, bro, because like I said, most of these goddamn telekinesis and aerokinesis videos are fake as fuck, bro. You got niggas adding suspenseful music and adding all this extra type of shit that does not have to be in that motherfucking video. And I feel like, bro, that most of these niggas who are claiming that they're doing telekinesis, bro, they got their homeboys, they got their girlfriends, they have their baby mamas standing next to a fan before a nigga records the motherfucking video. And when the nigga starts to record the video, they tell whoever's next to that fan to turn the fan on to give people the illusion that object is moving. For example, I've seen Black Flames videos where he's acting like he's moving shit with his hands and he's got music added to the shit. Bro, I bet this is the thing that he's been doing, bro. I bet he's been telling this me chick, whoever the fuck me is, he's like, I bet this is what he's saying. He's like, now me, you know, I've been getting exposed by Q-Dawg and Rahsaani or RS. So me, when I record the video, I want you to turn the fan on so I can give people the illusion that, you know, I'm moving the paper with my hands. Or these niggas will open up the window to their house so the wind can start moving that object. Ha! That's what really happens, y'all. I'm telling you, bro. These telekinesis videos are scripted as fuck, nigga. Then the last point I'm going to bring up, right, that I really want to talk about is niggas are claiming that they're against the system. But you see, the issue is niggas love to bitch, moan, and complain about what they don't want to do, about what the government is doing, about their job. And look, I get where you guys are coming from. You think I want to be a motherfucking slave and have to work a 9-to-5 job just to survive in this motherfucking system? Hell no, I don't want to do that. I'd rather be fucking chilling all motherfucking day, smoking weed, nigga, taking psychedelics, fucking bitches from all over the damn four corners of the earth, having babies everywhere. I'd rather be fucking and having sex and hugging and kissing with bitches from different types of planets and galaxies and other realms, nigga. I'd rather be doing shit like that. But you know why I can't do that? Because I have responsibility to take care of. Niggas love to complain about the government's doing this, the government's taking their rights, the government's doing that. But in other countries, when the government breaks their man-made laws that they create, or the government does some tyrannical shit, or the government takes away people's rights, nigga, what the fuck do people in other countries do, nigga? They riot, nigga. They motherfucking nip that shit in the bud, nigga. And they let the government know, like, hey, y'all, you're not gonna do this and that to us. That's the way Americans should be doing that shit. But unfortunately, over here in America, when the government be on some bullshit, people over here in America just love to sit on their ass and fucking complain all day and brag and moan. Or if they don't do that, niggas vote for a system that don't give two shits about them. I don't care if it's Republican, Democrat, fucking Libertarian. Nigga, they're all the fucking same thing. They're the same damn thing, bro. I'm telling y'all. Like I said, it's two birds, one stone, nigga. We've all been lied to, and we've all been played since we were born. But I swear to God, bro, like, most of you niggas just be negative as fuck, man. Always don't have anything good to say, man. Most of you niggas are like fucking Eeyore from Winnie the Pooh. My life is so shitty. Basically, most of you niggas be acting like fucking victims, my nigga. Let's be honest. But all this shit depends on your motherfucking mindset. If you have a shitty mindset, your life will be shitty. If you have more of a positive mindset like me, life will be good, my nigga. Life is what you make it. It depends on your mindset. It depends on your vibration, your environment, the things you surround yourself with, the people that you surround yourself with. Y'all get what I mean? And for the niggas that say that hate their jobs, this is my advice I would give to you. Try to find out what your purpose is in this life. Try to find out what interests you the most. I would say either leave that job, you know what I'm saying? Hustle, do what you gotta do. Don't sell no illegal drugs or anything like that. It'll get you in trouble. Now, I don't care if you do like simple stuff like weed, since that's becoming legal. Or you can be an entrepreneur and start your own business in order to make money, in order to be financially successful in this life. Or you can get into the stock market. You know what I'm saying? There's many things you can do in this motherfucking life. But I'm going to tell y'all something that this older guy at the college I go to, security guard, told me, a brother. He's like in his late 70s. He told me, don't ever do nothing with your life. Always do something with your life. And don't let life pass you by. Try to live life to the fullest the best way you can. And this is the message for the niggas who complain about every goddamn thing. Complain about shit like, oh, the world is so shitty. Oh, so negative. The world is this. The world is that. So my advice is, why don't you niggas get off your ass and find a way to make the world a better place? Come up with an idea or strategy to make the world a better, more positive place. Since there's too much negativity in this world, y'all feel me? But bickering, moaning, and continuing to complain will never address the problems in your personal life. It will never address the issues in this world. Negativity will never resolve any issues in your life or in the world in general. Another thing I be hearing niggas is talking about in the spiritual community and the occult community, right? They talking about that they're going to save the planet and that they're going to do this and that they're going to do that. So my question to you guys, to you niggas in these communities is, how are you saving the planet? What are you doing to save the environment or to save the planet? Are you guys protesting? Are you speaking out against the bullshit? You know what I'm saying? Are you speaking out against the motherfucking pollution? My question is, what are you niggas doing since y'all talking about y'all gonna do this and y'all gonna do that, talking about you gonna save the planet? What are you doing to actually help the environment and help Mother Nature, my nigga? Besides picking up the trash, what are you doing? Then the last thing I be hearing niggas talk about is that they are going to war against the government. I be hearing niggas talking about, yeah, we go war against the government, yeah, we go kill the pigs, yeah, we go kill everybody, every government official, this and that. We're gonna kill the celebrities, we're gonna kill the blood-sucking elites that eat children's blood and molest children and all that stuff. I be hearing niggas talking about, oh, the system gonna crash in 2026, oh, the system gonna crash in 2024 or 2030. Niggas be talking about, oh, that they gonna rebel against the system, or that they're against the system so much, and niggas are claiming that they want to be free, but why are you still working that 9-to-5 job? Why are you still choosing to be a slave if you want to be free so goddamn bad? So if you niggas want to be liberated, and if you want to be free, my question is, why don't you niggas try to overthrow the government right now? Why don't you try to overthrow the system right now? Instead of waiting X amount of years to do it, why can't you just rebel against the system right now and war against the government right now? Like, my question is, what are you niggas fucking waiting on, bruh? Let's get this shit over with. Let's be done here. Y'all get what I mean? But I feel like you niggas is giving people false hope, talking about that you gonna do this and that you gonna do that. If you say that you're gonna do something, do it. Be about that shit, bruh. But I already know that most of you niggas ain't about that gang shit, my nigga. Most of you niggas are fucking wannabe gangsters living in big ass rich houses, or you niggas are wannabe gangsters living in the suburbs. I got cousins that are about that gang shit, that are really about that shit, my nigga. I had two uncles and a granddaddy that were real steppers, that was about that shit, bruh. And on my mama's life, I swear, bruh, if these niggas was still here and I told them about the shit that you wannabe gangsters are doing, I guarantee you niggas that they would be on the ground, on the floor, laughing at you niggas. Then you got these goofy, loving light niggas talking about, oh, the only way to defeat the elites is through love, you know? We can be peaceful, this and that. And I swear, bro. Bruh, them niggas be on that Martin Luther King's off shit, my nigga. Talking about, oh yeah, nonviolence and still let the enemy fuck with you and still let the enemy fucking take advantage of you, hurt you, let the enemy do what they want, but oh, still be peaceful. I swear to God, bro. Some of you niggas still got that goddamn Jesus house Negro Christian mindset, bro. I don't care what race you niggas are. Then you got niggas talking about that they're gonna slaughter the elites with knives and swords. Then you got niggas talking about, yeah, we can overthrow the government by shooting them with AK-47s and expensive ass guns and shit. But bro, I swear to God, bro, these people are literally fucking stupid. Putting their business out there so the whole world can see, including Big Brother, and I bet them niggas is in their little covenants or wherever they're at, smoking a cigar, drinking wine, just laughing at these niggas, saying shit like this. They're like, oh, so these niggas think they want the smoke. Oh, we'll give them what they want. But be careful what you wish for. But I have a question for you so-called revolutionaries. So, what are you so-called revolutionaries gonna do when you run out of bullets? Since y'all act like y'all so gangster and you niggas talking about that you gonna shoot people, what you gonna do when you run out of bullets and you're surrounded by the pigs, nigga? You surrounded by the fucking military? What you niggas gonna do when all the grocery stores shut down? What you niggas gonna do when there's no more gas and you can't pump that gas station to fill up your motherfucking car? What you niggas gonna do when there's no more utilities in the house, like the heat, AC, nigga, water, light? What you gonna do then? I bet half of you niggas don't know how to survive on your own if there ever was a motherfucking apocalypse. But what are you niggas gonna do when you're surrounded by agents, the FBI, the military? Either, here's two things that are gonna happen. You either have two choices. One, either go back to jail and be a slave to this matrix, or two, you gonna get killed. But I already know that you niggas aren't ready for no motherfucking war. Y'all niggas ain't ready for no goddamn war. I know niggas are gonna be like, oh, you scary ass house Negro. No, I'm not no scary ass bitch. I think before I act, unlike most of you niggas. Nigga, the government got nuclear bombs. Nigga, the government has got weapons that society has never seen before, because the government has kept it hidden from the masses, but they show you the truth in plain sight in these superhero movies, TV shows, and these sci-fi fiction movies, which they always show you the motherfucking truth in plain sight about the weapons that they really have, my nigga. Nigga, the government got AI. They got motherfucking robots like the goddamn Terminator. The only hope that people have against the government, if they ever stood up against the government, if they ever warred against the government, if they ever rebelled against the government, is magic. That's the only hope that we have against the motherfucking government. Because the government uses black magic, or the government uses magic against us every fucking day. So do the elites, nigga. If niggas want true freedom, niggas should start quitting their jobs and watch this whole goddamn system crumble. Watch the whole damn system crumble if you really want to be free. If you want to be a free, spiritual, the free, spiritual, sovereign being that you are, quit working. Quit doing the shit that the system tells you. Throw out your motherfucking TVs.